Greetings everyone, esteemed guests and my dear fellow alumni, I'm Raghavan Vellayappan from the 1992 ENI. I feel very honored and privileged to be here today. I would like to welcome you all wholeheartedly to this pivotal moment in our lives. While we're gearing up for a cold weather ahead in the northern hemisphere of United States and Canada, this event offers us the warmth of renewed friendship and reigniting the moods and comradeship that our great Annamalai University has provided to us. John F. Kennedy once said, "I think the success of any school can be measured by the contribution the alumni make to our national life." Very true indeed. Many of our distinguished alumni have excelled in all walks of life, be it politics, entertainment, corporate boardrooms, or academics. They have created significant impact on this society. Our alumni have lived adequate following our university's motto with courage and faith. We have spread the mission of our great Annamalai University across the world passionately. Today, while we are commemorating our founder's birthday and the 90th anniversary of our university, I feel proud to stand in front of all of you to kickstart the proceedings of our grand inauguration of Annamalai University Alumni Association's US and Canadian chapters. We have lined up an exciting and informative program that includes speeches from eminent personalities, from our alumni and esteemed university officials. To top it all, we are going to be blessed with a wonderful concert as well. Annamalai Palkalaikkazhaga Munnal Manava Sangam, America matrum Canada Athiyayangalin Brahmanda Thuvakka Vizhavil Inaindulla Anaivarukkum Nenjaandha Vanakkam. சங்கம் வைத்து தமிழிசை வளர்த்த அண்ணாமலை அரசரின் பாரம்பரியம் போற்றும் விதமாக நமக்கு தமிழிசை விருந்து படைக்க இருக்கிறார் கலைமாமணி பத்மஸ்ரீ டாக்டர் திரு சீர்காழி சிவசிதம்பரம் அவர்கள். அவரின் இனிய குரலில் பல்கலைக்கழக வாழ்த்துடன் இன்றைய நிகழ்வை இனிதே துவங்குவோம். வாருங்கள்.
வணக்கம். முதலில் அரங்கேறுவது அண்ணாமலை பல்கலைக்கழக வாழ்த்து கவிமணி தேசிக விநாயகம் பிள்ளை அவர்கள் இயற்றிய தில்லைப்பதியுடையான் என்கிற வாழ்த்து. அதில் தில்லை அம்பல கூத்தரசன் அண்ணாமலை பல்கலைக்கழகம் அமைவதைக் கண்டு களித்து ஆடுகின்றான் என்று கவிமணி தேசிக விநாயகம் பிள்ளை அவர்கள் இயற்றியிருப்பார்கள். அதைத் தொடர்ந்து அரங்கேறுவது அண்ணாமலை அரசர் வாழ்த்து, டாக்டர் வா சுப மாணிக்கம் அவர்கள் இயற்றியது. நில்லாத செல்வத்தை நிலைக்கச் செய்தார் அண்ணாமலை அரசர் என்கிற அண்ணாமலை அரசர் வாழ்த்து அரங்கேறுகிறது. அதைத் தொடர்ந்து அரங்கேறுவது முத்தையவேள் டாக்டர் ராஜா சார் முத்தைய செட்டியார் அவர்களை பற்றி டாக்டர் வா சுப மாணிக்கம் அவர்கள் எழுதிய மன்னர் வாழ்த்து பாடல் முதலில் முதல் பாடலாக உங்களுக்காக அரங்கேறுகிறது. தில்லை பதியுடையான் சிற்றம்பலம் தன்னில் அல்லும் பகலும் நின்று ஆடுகின்றான் தில்லை பதியுடையான் சிற்றம்பலம் தன்னில் அல்லும் பகலும் நின்று ஆடுகின்றான் எல்லை கண் அண்ணாமலை மண் அமைத்த கலைக்கழகம் எல்லை கண் அண்ணாமலை மண் அமைத்த கலை கழுகும் கண்ணார கண்டு கழித்து எல்லைகள் அண்ணாமலை மண் அமைத்த கலைக்கழகம் கண்ணார கண்டு கழித்து எல்லைகள் அண்ணாமலை மண் அமைத்த கலைக்கழகம் கண்ணார கண்டு கழித்து நில்லாத செல்வத்தை நிலைக்கை செய்தான் நில்லாத செல்வத்தை நிலைக்கை செய்தான் நீங்காத கலை புரட்சி நிரம்ப செய்தான் நில்லாத செல்வத்தை நிலைக்க செய்தான் நீங்காத கலை புரட்சி நிரம்ப செய்தான் நில்லாத செல்வத்தை நிலைக்க செய்தான் நீங்காத கலை புரட்சி நிரம்ப செய்தான் கல்லாத இனமெல்லாம் கற்க வைத்தான் கல்லாத இனம் எல்லாம் கற்க வைத்தான் காணாத பெருங்கழகம் களத்து வைத்தான் காணாத பெரும் கழகம் களத்து வைத்தான் இல்லாத புலவர்களை இல்லாத புலவர்களை இருப்போராக்கி இணையாத தமிழ் புகழை ஈட்டிக் கொண்டான் இல்லாத புலவர்களை போராக்கி இணையாத தமிழ் புகழை ஈட்டிக் கொண்டான் வெல்லாத செயல் இல்லை என்று போற்று வெல்லாத செயல் இல்லை என்று போற்று விளங்கியவன் மண் அண்ணாமலையன் வாழ்கல்லாத செயல் இல்லை என்று போற்று விளங்கியவன் மண் அண்ணாமலையன் வாழ்க மண் அண்ணாமலையின் வாழ்கே
ஒரு அண்ணாமலை பல்கலைக்கழக விழாவிற்கு இதைவிட ஒரு அருமையானதொரு துவக்கம் கிடைத்திருக்க முடியாது. அருமையான ஒரு வாழ்த்து பாடல்களை செவிமடுத்த நாம் இனி நிகழ்ச்சிகளுக்கு செல்வோம். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐ வுட் லைக் டு வெல்கம் மிஸ்டர் முத்தழிலன் ஃப்ரம் 1990 மெக்கானிக்கல் பேட்ச், ஹூ இஸ் கரண்ட்லி எ சிஇஓ ஆஃப் செக்யூசோல் இன்கார்பரேட்டட். ஹி இஸ் பீன் அ பிரின்சிபல் ஆஃப் தமிழ் ஸ்கூல் அட் த சான் ஃப்ரான்சிஸ்கோ பே ஏரியா அண்ட் ஆல்சோ லீடிங் த டிஜிட்டல் டிரான்ஸ்ஃபர்மேஷன் எஃபர்ட்ஸ். ஹி இஸ் பீன் அன் ஆர்ஜே அண்ட் பார்ட் ஆஃப் கம்யூனிட்டி ஆர்கனைசேஷன்ஸ் வெல். வெல்கம் மிஸ்டர் முத்து, ப்ளீஸ் கிவ் அஸ் அன் ஓவர்வியூ ஆஃப் த யுனைடெட் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் சாப்டர்.
Welcome to Annamalai University Alumni Association of USA. Yes, it is official. We are an organization now and soon to be a non-profit. Are you one of them who live here or used to live here in the US? You are eligible to be part of us. We all enjoyed our college days in the prestigious institution, and some of us even were born and brought up in and around the university campus. I was one of them, and I grew up watching all kinds of activities happen in the university. When you think back, a lot of memories to cherish, ranging from we being students in the classrooms to all kinds of educational activities, our teachers and staff members, friendships that lasts even today, some finding the love of their life, and sports, musical concerts, events and seminars, and we taking charge of the railway station to Paris Corner, and of course an army of people around the ladies' hostel giving safety and security of all the girls in the campus. Oh well, I can keep going on and on. And of course, each and every one of you has a long list as well. Why do we need an alumni association? At least for three reasons. Some of us would love to just get together with our friends and alumni to just talk about the memories of the golden days. Or some of us with common interest in developing their business may find partners or interested in doing business together with each other, right? And of course, some of us had the opportunity of studying in the best of both worlds, Annamalai University back in India, and here one of the prestigious institutions in the USA. And I'm sure at some point in time, it crossed your mind that said, I wish I had this when I was in Annamalai. If that was the case, guess what? You may be interested in providing such opportunities to the coming generations back in the university there. These are just some of the things that we can do together, and many more to come. At this point in time, I would like to invite all the alumni in the US to become members so that we can sail this ship together. Welcome aboard Annamalai University Alumni Association of USA.
Thank you, Muthu. Now I would like to welcome Deepa Mohandas, our Singapen alumni from the land of maple syrup, Canada. She is a 1991 electrical engineering graduate from Annamalai University. After working as a biomedical professional for the last 25 years, she is now a consultant actively involved in the community development. Welcome, Deepa. Please give us an overview of the Canadian chapter.
Hi everyone, I'm happy and honored to be part of this historic launch of Annamalai University Alumni Association of Canada. When one mentions Canada, people only think of igloos, polar bears, or icebergs. But in reality, Canada has four beautiful seasons: a spring with cherry blossoms, hot summers where temperatures soar up to 40 degrees, a colorful autumn, and finally the winter where the temperatures drop to minus 40 degrees. Canada has been always a melting pot of cultures and has welcomed everyone with warmth and kindness. If you wonder how we Annamalaians not only embraced but thrived in such different and diverse environments and yet became successful, the credit lies with our alma mater, the great Annamalai University. Through rigorous curriculum, the friendships and camaraderie forged in the university halls, the modest beginnings of adulthood in our hostel life, and a campus filled with challenges, friendships, successes, failures, and determination, we were well prepared to take on life with courage and faith. Great things take time to build, they say. Yes, it took 90 years to form an official alumni association in North America. It is no ordinary feat, but with the support and efforts of many dedicated alumni, we made this possible. It is also worth mentioning that some of our Canadian alumni are key decision makers in federal and regional governments and in varied industries, including but not limited to IT, oil and gas, and academia. I'm happy to highlight that we have a dedicated Annamalai University campus operating out of Toronto, which offers diploma, degree, and postgraduate courses in music, dance, Tamil, and yoga. Over 1,000 individuals have graduated out of this campus since 2009. Today, I'm calling for all the Annamalaians in Canada to join our Alumni Association to avail this great platform to renew your friendships, to help build a nurturing community, to seek new horizons through our alumni network, and give back to our alma mater that gave us the very foundation for our successful life and career. I hope, similar to our Canadian chapter, we can foster change and growth across more alumni associations globally. Pogum paadai doorame, vaalum kaalam konjame. Enave, America matrum Canada vil vaalum annamalai sondangale, kalluri natpukkillai endrum muttrupulliye endrai ninaivu koorndu, indha Annamalai palgalai kalaga munnal maanavar sangathil inaiya vendugirum. Nandri, vanakkam.
Thank you, Deepa. Thank you for the clear overview and setting up the stage for the inaugural function. Now I would like to welcome Professor Dr. Murugesan Velayudham, esteemed Vice Chancellor of Annamalai University, to deliver the keynote address. He is a teaching veteran who has been teaching for more than 40 years and a very down-to-earth, easily accessible, humble personality. His flair for teaching at all levels of students is well known and well recognized. Welcome, sir.
Good morning to all alumni. My warm greetings and best wishes to all alumni of Annamalai University who are residing and contributing in North America significantly. I understand that the alumni in the US and Canada are occupying pivotal positions both in the federal government and in the corporate world. It gives me immense happiness and proud that our alumni are also in the forefront of enterprising entrepreneurs. We are proud of our alumni who are contributing to the economic development of the countries where they have settled down. The hallmark of our alumni is due to visionary founders of Annamalai University, Raja Sir Annamalai Chettiar and his son Raja Sir Muthai Chettiar, who started a multi-faculty university in a rural setup at Chidambaram in the year 1929, where the cosmic dancer Lord Nadraja residing. Because of the establishment of an university in the erstwhile South Arka district, an economically and socially backward district of Tamil Nadu, more than 1 million graduates passed out of the portals of this great campus during the last 90 years. The graduates are shining like stars in various walks of life across the globe. At this juncture, I just remind our distinguished alumni in the US and Canada and also in other parts of the world to think about your alma mater, recollect your memories and cherish the happiest moments of your youth which you spend at Annamalai University campus. Alumni should also seriously think about how best to pay back to your alma mater. I can equate this something like sons and daughters are paying back to their parents when they are in need. It is for this purpose Annamalai University Alumni Association was started in the year 2015, and in the last 2 years, the activities are geared up not only in Tamil Nadu but also in other countries. During the last 2 years, the Annamalai University Alumni Association have taken up various activities. I would like to touch upon the mission and vision of this Annamalai University Alumni Association. The mission of this association is to strengthen the goodwill and communication between the university and the large and diverse alumni to enhance their involvement in updating the skill set of present students and faculty and mobilize support to contribute to the development of the university. The vision statement of this association are to transform the university into a forefront public university among the stakeholders. It is proposed to bring this university within 100 ranks in the world ranking. Number two, the brand building through establishing research park, incubation center and a state-of-the-art central instrumentation facilities. Three, creation of professorial chairs. Number four, award of scholarships to economically weaker section of the students. Number five, give training and if possible placement for our existing students. With this ultimate motive, we have started this alumni association at Annamalai University. Now we understand that the wings are being spread across the other parts of the globe. The very purpose of this alumni association is to maintain an enduring, everlasting relationships in order to maintain update and manage the alumni record database and provide access and service to all university users. Sponsor activity, whatever the activity which the alumni is interested to sponsor, like seminar, conferences and workshops. I also request the alumni to sponsor facilities by providing materials for the modernization of laboratories, libraries, hostels and other buildings. It is very, very important to support the students. Share your experience and expertise and talent of the alumni, sponsor scholarships, provide career guidance and internships in nurturing future generation of students of Annamalai University. Post job and provide a platform for aspiring students. Organize get-togethers, alumni events to cherish your fond memories. Create a network of experts, professionals, practitioners, entrepreneurs to get acquainted to expand your trade. Under this purview, we have started this alumni association at Annamalai University, and now within India, there are chapters are being started in Salem, Coimbatore, Madurai, and also already chapters are started in Singapore, and it is also started in Gulf countries. I understand that the North America Annamalai University Alumni Association, namely USA and Canada, is starting a chapter of Annamalai University Alumni Association. It gives me immense pleasure to understand that you taken up the right stand to start an alumni association of North America comprising of Canada and USA. I understand the alumni of USA and Canada are doing extremely well in the Bay Area as well as in the other parts of USA. I am sure that this association will endure the full support and cooperation to the mother Annamalai University Alumni Association at Chidambaram. I am happy, very happy to inaugurate and also bless this North American Annamalai University Alumni Association. All the best, and I look forward favorably or very eagerly that we all celebrate the centenary year of Annamalai University in the year 2029. I once again wish the North American Annamalai University Alumni Association all the best and wish you good luck and all success for the North American Annamalai University Alumni Association. Wish you all the best and stay home, stay back and stay safe.
அடுத்தது மீண்டும் இசை விருந்து.
உள்ளத்தில் நல்ல உள்ளம் உறங்காதென்பது வல்லவன் வகுத்ததடா. கருணா வருவதை எதிர்கொள்ளடா. உள்ளத்தில் நல்ல உள்ளம் உறங்காதென்பது வல்லவன் வகுத்ததடா. கருணா தாய்க்கு நீ மகன் இல்லை, தம்பிக்கு அண்ணன் இல்லை. தாய்க்கு நீ மகன் இல்லை, தம்பிக்கு அண்ணன் இல்லை. ஊர் வழியேற்றாயடா நானும் உன்படி கொண்டேனடா நானும் உன்படி கொண்டேனடா உள்ளத்தில் நல்ல உள்ளம் உறங்காதின்பது வல்லவன் பகுத்ததடா மன்னவர் பணியேற்கும் கண்ணனும் பணி செய்ய மன்னவர் பணியேற்கும் கண்ணனும் பணி செய்ய உன்னடி பணிவானடா கர்ணா மன்னித்து அருள்வாயடா கர்ணா மன்னித்து அருள் உள்ளத்தில் நல்ல உள்ளம் உறங்காதின்பது வல்லவன் வகுத்ததடா கண்ணா மறுவதை எதிர்கொள்ளடா செஞ்சோற்று கடன் தீர்க்க சேராத இடம் சேர்ந்து செஞ்சோற்று கடன் தீர்க்க சேராத இடம் சேர்ந்து பஞ்சத்தில் வீழ்ந்தாயடா கர்ணா பஞ்சத்தில் வீழ்ந்தாயடா கர்ணா பஞ்சத்தில் வீழ்ந்தாயடா உள்ளத்தில் நல்ல உள்ளம் உறங்காதின்பது வல்லவன் வகுத்ததடா கர்ணா வருவதை எதிர்கொள்ளடா
தமிழ் இசைதான் எத்தனை சுகமானது. நன்றி ஐயா. நவ் ஐ வுட் லைக் டு வெல்கம் ப்ரொஃபஸர் ஆர் ஞானதேவன், ரெஜிஸ்ட்ரார் ஆஃப் அண்ணாமலை யூனிவர்சிட்டி, டு கிவ் இஸ் ஃபெலிசிட்டேஷன் அட்ரஸ். வெல்கம் சார்.
ரெஸ்பெக்டட் வைஸ் சான்சலர், டைரக்டர் ஆஃப் அலுமினி அசோசியேஷன் டாக்டர் சரவணன், வேல்யூட் அலுமினி ஆஃப் த கிரேட் அண்ணாமலை யூனிவர்சிட்டி, very good morning to each and every one of you. At the outset, I am so happy to learn that our alumni are launched Annamalai Alumni Association at USA and also at Canada. I congratulate everyone in this occasion, and this means that our institution is continuing to grow both laterally and vertically. I am even happier being an alumni of this great institution, and I have an opportunity to be with you in this fine event. This esteemed organization is established during 1929 by the foresighted vision of late Rajasar Annamalai Settiar of Chettinad, and became one of the important learning center in this globe. As per his dream, everything has become true and establishing an alumni center in the western part of earth, it is certainly vouching for his vision. The university has seen many vice chancellors, starting from Srinivasa Shastri, Sir C.P. Ramasamy Iyer, and presently with Professor V. Murugesan sir, an eminent scholar and an administrator with acumen. Since he is assuming office, he take much effort to strengthen the alumni association and working for the betterment of this institution. It is actually a mutual benefit for both the graduates and the institution. As an alumni, we have graduated with rich knowledge and we serve the place wherever we are. And at the same time, the institution is getting name and fame because of efficient output, besides getting a strong entanglement. A balanced mind, the capacity of look at problem from all its angle without fear and favor. To be tolerant of the other man's point of view, all these qualities are well imbibed by us as a graduate of this institution. And you undertake the task of carrying the message that Annamalai University is the cradle where all good service-minded people were born. I am not taking too much time, as I am aware of my limitation, to share with all great alumni of US and Canada. I am to request you to generally contribute both money and service to our alma mater, so that many younger generation will also join with you to satisfy the structure and spirit of it. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Mr. Jnanadevan, sir. Now, I would like to welcome Professor Dr. R. Saravanan, who is a chemical engineering professor and also director of the Alumni Relations Department in Annamalai University. He's been doing a wonderful job in the last couple of years in establishing the roots of the alumni and connecting with the alma mater. Welcome, Mr. Saravanan.
அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். ஐ ஃபீல் ஹானர்ட் இன் பீயிங் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி லான்ச் ஆஃப் தி அண்ணாமலை யூனிவர்சிட்டி யூஎஸ்ஏ அண்ட் கனடா சாப்டர்ஸ். இட் வில் கோ டவுன் இன் தி ஆனல்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி அண்ணாமலை யூனிவர்சிட்டி ஹிஸ்ட்ரி தட் ஆஃப்டர் 90 இயர்ஸ் ஆஃப் இட்ஸ் எஸ்டாப்ளிஷ்மெண்ட், அலுமினை ஃப்ரம் தி நார்த் அமெரிக்கா ஹாவ் கம் ஃபார்வர்ட் டு ஸ்டார்ட் அ சாப்டர் அண்ட் சப்போர்ட் தேர் அல்மா மேட்டர். ஓவர் த இயர்ஸ் த யூனிவர்சிட்டி ஹேஸ் ஃபெசிலிட்டேட்டட் மோர் தேன் 1 million கிராஜுவேட்ஸ் டு அச்சீவ் தேர் goals with character, personality, intellect and values for positioning their alma mater as a prestigious educational institution. In the past, there was not an exclusive department for alumni relations in the campus and could not communicate or build a network among alumni. Now an exclusive center has been established in 2018 and I occupy the position as director alumni relations, and I have been communicating to many of our alumni to enhance their involvement in bringing back the glory. I understand that there are nearly 6,000 plus alumni live in North America, spearheading many organizations successfully. Being the 90th anniversary of our alma mater and the 75th year, platinum jubilee year of the Faculty of Engineering and Technology, it is proposed to construct an exclusive building for the centralized instrumentation facility and a renovation of heritage buildings, restrooms, age-old hostels and many more activities with the support of alumni. At this juncture, I request your kind support to realize the dreams of the founders Dr. Raja Sir Annamalai Chettiar and Dr. Raja Sir Muthaiah Chettiar in the centennial year 2029. I wish the AUAA, USA and Canada all success. I would like to share a video of the service activities accomplished in the past 2 years with the support of alumni in the campus. Thank you everyone.
Thank you, Dr. Saravanan. That was wonderful to hear the significant progress that the alumni department has made in this last couple of years. Now, I would like to invite Dr. M.C. Madhavan from San Diego, one of the veteran alumni living in the United States. He's going to walk us down his memory lane of his 70 years of nostalgic association with our university. Yes, he's been associated with the university since 1949. That's when he first stepped into the university to his BA degree. Welcome, Dr. Madhavan.
Good evening, friends. What a delightful evening it is to rejoice and reconnect with old friends after many years of separation, to thank the benefactor who made our education journey possible. We are who we are because of his vision. Raja Sir conceived the idea of bringing together cosmic and morphic energy, Mengyanam, with scientific inquiry, Vignanam, to remove ignorance, Anjanam. During his visit to England, Annamalai Chettiar was very much impressed by Oxford University and its impact on British society. He wanted to establish a higher education institution in India in memory of his mother, Meenakshi Achi. He followed the lead of his older brother, Ramaswamy Chettiar, who established a high school in Chidambaram in 1912. Sir Annamalai established Sri Meenakshi College in 1920, followed by colleges for the study of Tamil, Tamil Isai, and Sanskrit. With the passing of necessary legislation by the Madras Legislature, Annamalai University was born in 1929 from the seeds of Meenakshi College. A magnificent gesture by one man to found a university. King George VI conferred the hereditary title of Raja of Chettinad on Sir Annamalai in 1929, a glorious recognition for his service to the nation. Raja Sir was always occupied with the thought of how to make Annamalai like Oxford. This led him to persuade people of great eminence to accept the vice-chancellorship of the university. He asked his eldest son Muthaiya to go and meet Right Honorable Srinivasa Sastri, Divan Bahadur Sir Samuel Ranganathan, Rao Bahadur Sir K.V. Reddy and Professor Rudraswamy. Such a galaxy of savants leading the university had a few parallels in India at that time. Raja Muthaiya followed the blueprint outlined by his father. He also succeeded in persuading very distinguished Dr. R.K. Shanmugam Chettiar, the first finance minister of independent India, and Dr. Sir C.P. Ramaswamy Iyer to become vice chancellors. Distinguished scientist Dr. S.G. Manavala Ramanujam and former Madras Police Service Commission chairman Dr. D.M. Narayan Swami Pillai were also vice chancellors in the 50s. The founder's vision to make Annamalai University recreate Kamba Ramayanam from thousands of old Palmyra leaf texts, inculcate and develop Tamil Isai, and emphasize scientific reasoning. His quest for high quality faculty to anchor the university's growth led him to offer appointments to people from different parts of the country and offer scholarships to promising lecturers to go to British universities to strengthen the quality of Annamalai University faculty. A great many very distinguished academicians joined the university to work toward the Raja's vision. During the 50s, Dr. Balayya of chemistry, Karmayogi Seshaya of zoology, Dr. Singh of botany, Dr. Meenakshi Sundaram of linguistics created healthy environment for research and it started to bloom. Student life during the 1950s was very productive and enjoyable. There were about 1,900 students in 1949. Class sizes were very small, particularly in honors and MA classes. Erudite faculty members were very forthcoming and helping the students to achieve their goals. Library facilities were one of the best in the nation. Hostel facilities were adequate. Food choices and quality were enviable and tasty. Mess charges were shared equally among the students between 30 and 35 rupees per month. Many fond memories were made during the eagerly anticipated monthly feast in the mess hall. Thanks to Professor LKG, sports activities played an important role in student life. So did the National Cadet Corps. Student unions and monthly department club activities provided ample opportunities to discuss academic related subjects and political and social issues. Many anomaly university students became influential political leaders in the state. The only area that was in short supply was entertainment, but melodious Friday music concerts quenched the thirst for beauty and color. Opportunities for men and women getting together outside academic activities were rare. This led to many disappointments. Yet, there were few successful marriages between students, between faculty and women students. Yes, I helped a pair of lovebirds. My life at Annamalai is full of happy memories, both as a student and as a lecturer. Thanks to the encouragement and support of J.D. Somasundaram, Irsu Pillai and others, I had the leadership roles in Student Union, Social Service League, Annamalai University, Co-op Distos. I had the very pleasant task of welcoming the first President of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, on February 9, 1953, on behalf of the student body. As a lecturer during 1955-60, I was again fortunate to get involved in faculty club events and organize special economic seminars for outstanding economists. Professor Sonachalam and I organized the 42nd annual Indian Economic Association conference in December 1959 for the first time at the university. I owe a lot to my mentors during my student days and faculty days, particularly to Dr. Anantharaman, Professor Ramakrishna Iyer and Dr. Balayya. In May 1960, the US Consul General Office informed me that I was selected to receive Fulbright Fellowship to study at the University of Wisconsin. After 3 years at Madison, I returned briefly in June 63 before joining the World Bank, first from India under its prestigious Young Professional Program. Thus began my life in the United States. In 1979, Rajasar invited me, Biramani, Sadiq and others to participate in the afternoon session of the Golden Jubilee celebrations. I owe a debt of gratitude to Rajasar Annamalai Muthiyachettiar for his encouragement and love for over 3 decades. I am proud to be a product of Annamalai. Let us do the best to make our alma mater shine and reach the vision of the founder before the centenary year. Thank you. Lord Nataraja and Paswadeswara bless you.
Thank you, Mr. Madhavan. That was nostalgic. Now let me welcome Mr. Raj Masood, a veteran alumni from Canada. He graduated with civil engineering honors degree in 1960, and he has been part of landmark bridges in Canada and also restoration of historic buildings like Legislative Building of Ontario and Parliament Building in Ottawa. So he can be fondly called as a bridge man who is playing a major role in bridging all the Annamalaians in this part of the world. Welcome, sir.
Hello, everyone. I am Raj Mosur. Vanakkam. Glad to be part of this inaugural launch of Alumni Association of USA and Canada. When I graduated from Annamalai University in 1960, most of us used to have 4 or 5 job offers before we finish our final exams, while many of my batchmates joined Neyveli Lignite Corporation. I worked briefly for a consulting architect's office in Public Works Department, Madras, and later I joined IIT Kharagpur to teach in the architecture department along with consulting work for UNESCO. I moved to Canada in 1965 to do my master's in structures at the University of Waterloo and became a consultant for a firm where I was designated as structural specialist in bridges and buildings by the province of Ontario. Very few people given this designation at that time. I owe all my success and standing in the business world for more than 45 years to my basic training, which I received in Annamalai University. Our group IATA 5660 connected with each other in 2010 to celebrate the Golden Jubilee under the guidance of Dr. T.R. Jagdishan, Dean Emeritus of Anna University. As a token of our appreciation to Alma Mater, our group furnished the lecture hall in our engineering building with a state-of-art media room. We continue to participate in community work as a way of giving back to the society. The friendship we developed during our Annamalai hostel days still binds us together to help each other. We also celebrated our Diamond Jubilee in 2020. As you all know, Annamalai University is celebrating its 90th year since the inception of the university in 1929. Recently, the Chennai Alumni Chapter was inaugurated. We are now inaugurating the alumni, both USA and Canada. In 2029, we'll be celebrating the centenary of the university. By then, I am sure that all the Annamalai alumni will be integrated around the world to meet the dreams of our founder, Raja Sir Annamalai Chettiar, to make Annamalai like Oxford or any Ivy League institutions in the world. At this point, I would like to introduce an esteemed alumni who is from the first batch of engineering, Thiru Sivaraman, graduated in 1949. It is a privilege and pleasure to listen to his speech about his college days. We thank him for his participation and wishes.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce myself, a student of the first batch of the Engineering and Technology faculty during the years 1945-49, and wish to take you back 75 years in time. While I was at the university, India was under the British rule. The Union Jack used to fly on top of the clock tower of the administrative block. The administrative block had a clock tower, but had no clock. Since the engineering and technology faculty of Annamalai University was started only in 1945, we had no buildings for the engineering college or the hostel. Our classes were held at the arts and science blocks, and we were accommodated in the university east block, west block, and new block hostels. The campus was verdant with lots of gardens and open spaces, and a windmill used to pump water to the hostels. The university had a boating canal, sports pavilion, students' union hall, hospital, and university guest house. The Shastri Hall used to be vibrant with meetings of the Tamil Sangam, Kerala Samaj, Andhra Association, literary associations, and other departmental associations. In those days, All India Radio news was broadcast in the mornings and evening at our hostel block to keep up to date with the news. Our monthly expenses in those days used to be about 50 rupees only. While I was in the university, Mahatma Gandhiji passed through Chidambaram railway station, and the train stopped very close to the university campus. We then had the great privilege to see and pay our respects to the father of the nation. Eventually, when India became independent in 1947 August, we, the members of the Indian Student Congress, proudly hoisted the Indian tricolor flag at the very same clock tower. No wonder, as alumni of our university, whenever we meet in any part of the world, we experience an immediate affection and bonding between us. I convey my hearty wishes to the future generations of our university. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Raj. அடுத்தது மீண்டும் இசை விருந்து.
கவிஞர் சஞ்சய் வாணன் அவர்கள் இயற்றிய முயன்றால் முடியாதா என்கிற கீர்த்தனம் அடுத்தரங்கேறுகிறது. அண்ணாமலை அரசர் அண்ணாமலை பல்கலைக்கழகத்தில் முதன் முதலில் மீனாட்சி கல்லூரி என்கிற தமிழ்க் கல்லூரியை ஆரம்பித்து பின்னர் தமிழிசைக்கான இசைக்கல்லூரியை ஆரம்பித்தவர். அவரது மனப்பாங்கினை வெளிப்படுத்துகின்ற பாடல் கவிஞர் தஞ்சைவாணன் அவர்களது வரிகளில் இப்பொழுது உங்களுக்காக அருகேறுகிறது. முயன்றால் முடியாதா, முயன்றால் முடியாதா, முயன்றால் முடியாதா, கொஞ்சம் முயன்றால் முடியாதா, முது பெரும் தமிழினில் அறிவியல் கலைகளை பயின்றால் பெரும் தமிழினில் அறிவியல் கலைகளை பயின்றால் புரியாத முயன்றால் முடியாத கல்லணையை கட்டவில்லையா, கரிகாலன் கல்லணையை கட்டவில்லையா, மிகையாக நில் அதனால் கிட்டவில்லையா, கரிகாலன் கல்லணையை கட்டவில்லையா, மிகையாக நில் அதனால் கிட்டவில்லையா, தஞ்சை பெருங்கோயில் தஞ்சை பெருங்கோயில் ஒரு யானர் திட்டம் அல்லவா, தஞ்சை பெருங்கோயில் ஒரு யானர் திட்டம் அல்லவா, தஞ்சை பெருங்கோயில் தமிழ் பொறியாளர் திட்டம் அல்லவா, இவையெல்லாம் எட்டவில்லையா, உன் புத்திக்கு இவையெல்லாம் எட்டவில்லையா, முயன்றால் முடியாத முது பெரும் தமிழினில் அறிவியல் கலைகளை பயின்றால் புரியாத பெருத்த புகழ் தமிழ் சித்தர் வந்தார், பெருத்த புகழ் தமிழ் சித்தர் வந்தார், பொருத்தமுடன் மூலிகை எடுத்து தந்தார், பெருத்த புகழ் சித்தர் எழுந்து வந்தார், பொருத்தமுடன் மூலிகை எடுத்து பல்லோரும் இரிது வாழ இணையில மருத்துவம் தந்துரைத்தார், இணையில மருத்துவம் தந்துரைத்தார், முயன்றால் முடியாத அறிவியல் கலைகளை பயின்றால் புரியாதா மொயல்தால் முடியாதா மொது பெரும் தமிழினில் அறிவியல் கலைகளை பயின்றால் புரியாதா மொது பெரும் தமிழினில் அறிவியல் கலைகளை பயின்றால் புரியாதா
தமிழ் இசைதான் எத்தனை சுகமானது. நன்றி ஐயா. Now I would like to welcome another veteran alumni, Mr. Subramaniam Devanayagam. He is an alumni of Annamalai University, having received his bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering in 63 and master's degree in industrial engineering in 66. He is a prolific academician. He started his teaching career in Thyagaraja College of Engineering for 3 years before coming to the USA to enroll in Texas Tech University for his doctoral degree. Since then, he has served in the faculty at Texas Tech University, University of Texas Arlington, and Tennessee Tech University. He has done research work and an eminent scholar. He has served several professional organizations in various elected positions. He is now a retired faculty member of Tennessee Tech University with the official status as Associate Dean of Engineering Emeritus. He is going to walk us through his memories with Annamalai University. Welcome, sir.
Greetings. We are all enjoying an excellent music program by Professor Sivachidambaram and his party. Please permit me to interrupt for a few minutes with an important message. Well, let's go back to the time when we went to Annamalai University as a student. We had excellent teachers, outstanding facilities, good administrators, and we enjoyed our time and we learned whatever we were doing. The successful career that we have now, I can tell you, and you will agree with me, that it's mostly due to the education we received at Annamalai University. There should be no doubt about it. Okay. Now, we know that the university has gone through some difficult times of late. Let's not get into the reasons of it. Right now, we have a new vice chancellor for the last couple of years. Dr. Murugesan, who is doing his best to put back the university in a very positive atmosphere and bring it back to its old glory. He is asking for our help. He is attacking the issue in many fronts. One of the areas that he wants to improve is the university alumni relationship. He is trying to give more responsibility or get us involved in the higher levels of administration and policy making of the university. This is the time we need to help it, which is absolutely important. Okay. Now that help, what we are talking about, can be in many different ways. Of course, you may be thinking immediately, he's going to ask for money. Yeah, money is important. I'm not asking for money. What I'm going to ask for is your effort and ideas to implement some of the programs that can be developed in the meantime by working with the university and working as a group here. One of the ideas that came up recently is to increase the interaction, collaboration of university faculty and students from Annamalai University to well-known universities in North America. The reason they've chosen me to talk about it is under the Obama-Singh agreement, several years back, for a duration of about 3 years, we had faculty members coming from Annamalai University to my institution here, Tennessee Tech University. We had about a dozen faculty members and about 20 students for various periods of time participating in the research activities going on. And they gained a lot, they went back. And we want to spread that experience to more universities. And we need your help for that. In fact, about 10 days back, we had a meeting, a virtual meeting with Dr. Raj Natarajan of Maryland. And he has also promised, he is much involved with the administration, state level administration in the state of Maryland. He has also promised. What I'm asking you is to think of in these lines. How can we return anything to Annamalai University that will be of value to future generations? What I'm saying is, Annamalai ku alumni aatrum nandri adanai kundrilida chayal. Enna solrenna, இந்த அண்ணாமலை யூனிவர்சிட்டிங்கிற விளக்கு இப்போது ஒரு குடத்தில் விட்ட மாதிரி இருக்கு. அந்த குடத்திலிருந்து எடுத்து ஒரு குன்றின் மேல் வைத்தால்தான் அதனுடைய பெருமை உலகெங்கும் தெரியும். இதற்கு நாம் எல்லோரும் ஒன்றாக சேர்ந்து பாடுபட வேண்டும். ஓகே, தமிழில் இன்னொரு வார்த்தை, ஊர் கூடித்தான் தேர் இழுக்க வேண்டும் என்று. அதை செய்வோம். அந்த உதவி நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் செய்வீர்கள் என்ற நம்பிக்கையுடன் நான் அதை நிறுத்திக் கொள்கிறேன். மே காட் பிளஸ் அஸ் ஆல். Thank you,
Mr. Devanagam sir. Now I would like to welcome one of our veteran alumni, Mr. Sokalingam Sankannappan, who has been living in the United States for more than 50 years. He graduated with Mechanical Engineering BE Honors degree from Annamalai University in 1965 and came to the US in 1968. He is very well known for his community works in USA and in India. He is notably the founder of Bharati Kalai Mandram, Houston, Texas, founder secretary of Sri Meenakshaman Temple, founder president of Gopio Houston chapter, founder Kannappan Arts Museum, Pearland, Texas, and most recently the president of Houston Tamil Chair Activities. Welcome, sir.
Kalingam Sam Kannappan from Houston, Texas, originally from Natarajan Kottai. I joined Annamalai University in 1960. When I attended the interview, I have to travel by train during railway workers' strike. When I got down at Chidambaram railway station at midnight, I have to cross the railway road to reach the university engineering building. First 2 years, I was in hostel dormitory, which was a modified strength of materials lab. And in the mess, the clerk who takes down the extras remembered every person's name and kept a correct record of the purchase. When the Vice Chancellor Judge Subramaniam integrated the engineering hostel with arts science hostel, Vice Chancellor Satsipi Ramsyamayyar took the position for the second time. He served earlier at the university as Vice Chancellor. Indo-China War started in 1963. I was serving as the Joint Secretary of the Engineering Association. The courses were accelerated to graduate more engineers due to the war. So I was promoted to Secretary of Engineering Association. 7 of my classmates had arrears, and the next batch is integrated engineering course, which is much more difficult than the old regulation. So I met with the Vice Chancellor Sir C.P. Ramaswamy Iyer in his bungalow and requested him to conduct special examination for my classmates. Vice Chancellor asked, "You passed, why are you asking?" I told the Vice Chancellor, "My classmates will not pass in the new regulation." He said, "Sorry." I came back and I told the Dean, Lieutenant Colonel Paul, but he did not believe me till the instructions came from the Vice Chancellor for conducting special examination for 7 of my classmates. Then they graduated with me in 1965. Professor K. Rajaram was the warden and he was very strict with students, but he was very kind. He recommended me for the best student award, but one of the professors objected, so I did not get it. But I had 100% attendance in my final year engineering, so I was given attendance prize. The engineering exhibition took place at the university. I managed the train and Professor Sadiq managed the boat. After I completed the final year examination, I joined PAG College of Technology in 4 days after the examination. I went back to Annamalai University for the convocation. I spoke at the reception. Everyone laughed when I said I could have joined the Air Force except the Vice Chancellor. I learned my leadership skills at Annamalai University, which was very helpful for me in later years. I wish all the students of Annamalai University bright future, and I thank you all for this opportunity to speak to you. Mika Nandri.
Thank you, Kanapan sir. Thank you for sharing your golden moments with us. அடுத்தது மீண்டும் இசை விருந்து.
அடுத்து அரங்கேறுவது பாவேந்தர் பாரதிதாசன் அவர்கள். இன்பம் சேர்க்க மாட்டாயா கண்ணே, துன்பம் நேர்கையில் யாழெடுத்து இன்பம் சேர்க்க மாட்டாயா என்று குஞ்சிய தமிழ் வரிகளை கொண்ட பாடல் அடுத்து அரங்கேறுகிறது. துன்பம் நேர்கையில் யாழெடுத்து நீ இன்பம் சேர்க்க மாட்டாயா கண்ணே, இன்பம் சேர்க்க மாட்டாயா. துன்பம் நேரில் யாழெடுத்து நீ இன்பம் சேர்க்க மாட்டாயா கண்ணே, இன்பம் சேர்க்க மாட்டாயா. நல் அன்பிலான நெஞ்சில் தமிழில் பாடி நீ அன்பிலானெஞ்சில் தமிழில் பாடு நீ அல்லல் நீக்க மாட்டாயா கண்ணே, அல்லல் நீக்க மாட்டாயா கண்ணே. வன்பும் எளிமையும் சூழும் நாட்டிலே ஆ
பண்பும் எளிமையும் சூழும் நாட்டிலே வாழ்வில் உணர்வு சேர்க்க எம் வாழ்வில் உணர்வு சேர்க்க நீ அன்றை நற்றமிழ் கூத்தின் முறையினால் ஆடி காட்ட மாட்டாயா கண்ணே ஆடி காட்ட மாட்டாயா அறமிதென்றும் மரமிதென்றுமே அருகில்லாத போது அறமிதென்றும் மரம் போது தமிழ் இறைவனாரின் திருக்குறளிலே ஒரு சொல் இறைவனாரின் திருக்குறளிலே ஒரு சொல் இயம்பி காட்ட மாட்டான் கண்ணே இயம்பி காட்ட மாட்டாயா கண்ணே கண்ணே
தமிழ் இசைதான் எத்தனை சுகமானது. நன்றி ஐயா. Now I would like to welcome Mr. Suresh Pudigai from 1976 Chemical Engineering batch. After obtaining his master's degree in petroleum engineering, he has had a successful career in the upstream sector with several major oil exploration companies across the world. He has worked in from inside the Arctic Circle to deepest water areas of South America and Africa in various positions. Currently, he is settled down in Houston as an independent consultant. He is going to take us through the scholarship and endowment opportunities that we can be part of. Welcome, Mr. Suresh.
Vanakkam. My name is Suresh. Suresh Pudigai. 1976 Chemical Engineering batch. I have about 40 years experience in upstream industry, and in my career I've been fortunate to work in almost all the continents. Currently I am based in Houston, Texas. So we all have experience from young undergraduate in Norman City and living in a small town atmosphere closer to a true culture of Tamil Nadu, and have developed a fondness as we have with our own family. The founder, Sir Annamalai Chettiar, had the foresight to set up several large endowments for the future generation. And let's not forget, we are all beneficiaries, some way or the other, for his benevolent endowments. We who are in North America, or made our North America our home, are blessed, and should we not do our part in supporting various projects at our alma mater for the benefit of future generations? We know that a student from a rural university does not get all the facilities available for a student living in a bigger city, and Annamalai falls into the same category. We have had several discussions with alumni out here, and we have some of them have come up with some novel ideas, and we have come up with few suggestions on what we can do even with a small contributions. Some of them are unique and out-of-the-box ideas and applies to the current situations. Permit me to add, to bring some of them here and discuss it with you. Why not we support and improve the bandwidth in the campus? Maybe we can set up a telemedicine at the medical college, facility at a medical college, and be a link to other specialized areas. Why not create an urban forest using the skill set of the people in the agricultural college? We can look at public-private partnership to generate solar and other unconventional power within the campus. Can we help in improving the facilities in our hostels? Why not support endowments to bring distinguished speakers from industries and from the central research institutes? Arrange commercial industry softwares from here, which can be used on a non-commercial basis for training of both faculty and students, which will give them a heads up when they go out into the industries. Maybe we can contribute for some subscription of magazines to various departments, which is not available right now. Basically, we want to see how we can help leapfrog Anomaly University into this second wave of digital revolution. Our ultimate goal is to make Anomaly University a smart city campus of a tier 2 city in India. Ours is a non-profit organization, and we can funnel and facilitate your contributions and make sure it goes for what it is designated for and fulfill your aspirations to give something back to the university. We are a nascent group, we are open for suggestions, and please, but also look at how you can support us. Please address any questions you have by going on to our website and asking questions, and also contribute in whatever way you can. மிக்க நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
Thank you, Mr. Suresh. Now I would like to welcome Mr. Murali Pathy, 1989 Mechanical and Production Engineering graduate from Anomaly University. He was president of the Rotaract Club of Chidambaram then and had led many community projects benefiting the Anomaly University and Chidambaram. After 10 years of career in India, Ashok Leyland Ford, he came to the USA in 1999 and currently is a founder CEO of a software firm and supporting social projects in Washington, D.C., where he lives currently. Welcome, Mr. Murali.
So, I'm sure you're all enjoying the concert, munching through the captive speeches from the keynote speakers and raking your brain, thinking about what you can do for our university. Before we get to the next segment of the concert, I'd like to quickly recognize and acknowledge all who made this evening possible. First and foremost, our recognition goes to Raja Sir Annamalai Chettiar, founder of Annamalai University, and his illustrious son, Raja Sir Muthiah Chettiar, dignitaries from our alma mater. Professor V. Murugesan, our Vice Chancellor, who is the epicenter of the current enthusiasm for all alumni. Professor R. Jnanadevan, Registrar, Professor R. Saravanan, Director, Alumni Relations, Dr. A. Prabhakar, Deputy Director, Distance Education, who were instrumental in creation of our Alumni Association. Today's program was very lively because of the special Tamil music. Thanks to Padma Shri Dr. Sirgali G. Sivasidambaram, who is also the Honorary Professor for Faculty of Fine Arts, Dr. Badri Narayanan Violin, Thiruvaru Sai Krishna Mrudangam, Sri Ramdas Gadam, Sri Raghuram Morsing. Technology support for the concert was provided by Sushma Raghunathan and our own alumni from Chennai, Mahindra Kumar and Gopi. We have two distinguished, very senior alumni amongst us today. From India, Mr. T.S. Sivaraman, 1945-49, who is the first batch of engineer to come out of our university. At 93, sir, your passion for the university is steroid shot for our motivations. Dr. T. R. Jagadeesan, 1960 mechanical, He is performing a pivotal role working with our Vice Chancellor to establish alumni operations. He recently arranged for a teleconference of senior alumni across the globe, which was very motivating. Thanks for being with us, sir. The pillars of our USA and Canadian Association, our own senior alumni, Professor M.C. Madhavan, San Diego, California, Mr. Paul Pandian, Houston, Texas, Mr. Raj, Missouri, Canada, Dr. Devanayagam, Tennessee, Mr. Sukalingam, Sam Kanapan, Houston, Texas. Thanks for being the pillars you are. A matching fundraiser program was run, and Mr. Suresh Pudigai, President NI America LLC USA, had taken a lead on this, and funding for this came from outside the USA also. Mr. Shiva Ilanahai, Managing Director, CTEX Petrochemicals, Chennai, Mr. Desigan Raghunathan, President, Innovative Projects Consultants, LLC, Sharjah, UAE. Thanks for your support. Architect Pradivi Prabhakar, thank you for your design, for your support in terms of designing the instrumentation building, which is the press project for our Vice Chancellor. 30 plus core alumni members were behind the scenes working for over a couple of months to make this event possible. Thanks to all of you. Thanks to all alumni for joining us today, and continue to enjoy the concert. Vanakkam.
Thank you, Murali. Now it's time to conclude this grand occasion. A wise man once said, feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. So I would like to first thank all our viewers for their support. Thank all our speakers who have graced us today with their presence. And thank all the core committee members for their enormous contribution in making this event happen. And last but not the least, I would like to thank them for giving me this opportunity to be part of this great event. Hoping this event could help our alumni reconnect in all levels and rekindle their proud Annamalaiyan feel. America மற்றும் Canada வாழ் அண்ணாமலை நட்புகளே, வாருங்கள் ஒன்றிணைவோம். பல்கலைக்கழகத்தின் முன்னேற்றத்தில் பங்கெடுப்போம். மலடா அண்ணாமலை என்ற பெருமிதத்தோடு பந்தத்தை தொடர்வோம். அண்ணாமலை அரசர் வாழ்த்துடன் துவங்கிய இந்த இனிய நிகழ்வு ஒரு இறை வாழ்த்துடன் இனிதே நிறைவுறுகிறது. இதுவரை இணைந்திருந்த அனைவருக்கும் இதயபூர்வ நன்றியுடன் விடைபெறுகிறேன். உங்கள் அன்பன் ராகவன்.
ஆறிரு தடந்தோள் வாழ்க அறுமுகம் வாழ்க ஆறிரு தடந்தோள் வாழ்க அறுமுகம் வாழ்க வெற்பை கூறு செய் தனிவேல் வாழ்க குக்குடம் வாழ்க செவ்வேள் ஏறிய மங்கை வாழ்க யானை தன் அணங்கு வாழ்க மாறில வள்ளி வாழ்க வாழ்க சீரடியார் எல்லாம் வாழ்க வாழ்க உலகம் வாழ்க உலகம் வாழ்க உலகம் வாழ்க இன்பமே சூழ்க எல்லோரும் வாழ்க இன்பமே சூழ்க எல்லோரும் வாழ்க இன்பமே சூழ்க எல்லோரும் வாழ்க
இன்பமே சூழ்க எல்லோரும் வாழ்க.